大家好。咁咧，首先喺度多谢大家购买我呢只 Extreme City Manipulation 嘅 DVD。咁咧喺呢只 DVD 里面咧，我哋需要搞一啲比较难少少嘅 CD 嘅花式啊，一啲 CD 嘅难啲嘅效果啊，或者一啲难啲嘅手法咁样。咁如果大家有睇我之前关于 CD Manipulation 嘅 DVD 咧，咁我谂大家都已经学识咗啲基本嘅方法啦，即系点样去拍一啲 CD 啊，点去变啲 CD 出嚟咁样。咁但如果大家冇買過都唔緊要，因為我呢只碟裏面咧都會包括咗一個 basic session 啊，即係有基本部分，咁都會教翻大家一啲基本方法，點可以做一啲 palming， 同埋點樣去做啲 CD 嘅 production 出嚟嘅。咁跟住喺第二嘅部分咧，我哋就開始教一啲難啲啦、深少少嘅花式同埋一啲嘅手法啦。咁咧每個手法同每個花式都係獨立嘅，咁大家可以獨立咁去學曬每一個花式先。咁去到最尾一部分咧，我哋就會有幾個唔同嘅 routine 啦。咁嗰啲 routine 咧就係包括咗我哋喺裏面每一個手法同每一個嘅花式點樣將佢可以加埋一齊變成一個 routine 咁樣。咁我哋裏面咧都會有四個嘅基本嘅 routine 可以俾大家參考一下嘅。咁希望大家咧睇完我呢套碟之後咧，咁可以對 CD 嘅魔術咧有更加進一步嘅認識。咁同埋咧可以盡量嘗試用裏面每一個嘅手法加埋一齊去創造自己嘅流程，創造自己嘅節目出嚟。咁好啦，咁事不宜遲啦，咁我都唔阻大家，請大家慢慢享用我呢隻碟裏面嘅內容啦。好啦，首先咧，等我同大家講下 perfect palm 係點做先啦。perfect palm 其實咧就係將隻 CD 收隻手呢個位置，咁樣前面睇出嚟咧就會係見到手背遮住隻 CD 噶啦，後面睇就咁樣啦，前面睇係見唔到隻 CD 嘅。咁其實點做法呢？將隻 CD 咧擺喺手嘅時候，我哋用無名指將佢穿落呢個窿嗰度。咁我哋就唔需要攝入去嘅喎，只需要攞大少少去喺身個窿裏面就 OK 噶啦。咁其他手指咧，你見到啦，呢手指全部彎落嚟啦，食指伸直去。咁樣前面睇咧啱啱遮咗隻 CD 嘅。咁我哋最緊要就係揸隻 CD 嘅時候咧，千祈唔好將隻手太過斜啦。太斜見到後面啦，斜前面就見到上面噶啦。最緊要保持 CD 係個水平嘅位置，咁樣擺呢個位置，咁就好自然，觀眾就唔會發現噶啦。呢個就係 perfect palm。好啦，學完 perfect palm 之後咧，我哋就講下 perfect production 點做法啦。咁 perfect production 咧，其實同 perfect palm 差唔多，將啲 CD 咧擺喺 perfect palm 嘅位置啦，咁樣，咁觀眾就見唔到 CD 啦。跟住咧，我哋就要將佢變出嚟啦，一隻一隻咁樣將佢推出嚟。好啦，後面睇係點嘅咧？手指公喺個碟面推出嚟，食指。撳上落嚟，推出嚟，撳落嚟，喺前面睇，推出嚟，撳落嚟，推出嚟，撳落嚟。咁我記住啦，個無名指咧，咁只係啱啱可以 hold 住啲 CD 就 OK 啦，咁就唔需要穿曬入嚟個窿裏面嘅。如果唔係咧，就好難再推出嚟噶啦。推變出嚟，推變出嚟，推變出嚟。咁好啦，我哋真正變嘅時候咧。我哋要点做呢？我哋将佢只手伸直，推一拉变出嚟嗰时咧，只手拉翻入嚟，推拉推拉。咁你见到咧，拉同埋揿落嚟嘅动作咧，同一时间做嘅。呢个咧就叫做 perfect production 啦。好啦，跟住咧，我哋講下 tank high palm 係乜嘢嚟噶啦？原來 tank high palm 咧，就將個 CD 收喺手，用手指公穿落個窿度，咁樣揸住佢，呢個就叫 tank high palm 啦。咁好啦，喺前面睇咧一樣啦，都係見唔到個 CD 啦。後面睇原來係咁樣嘅，CD 擺喺中指同無名指中間呢個位置，手指公可以穿落個窿裡面。咁但系就唔使穿晒落去啦，只需要固定佢唔喐就得噶啦。好啦， 最重要就是记住 CD 呢要保持水平，千万不要这样斜或者这样斜，手背对着观众，那观众就不会见到 CD 的了，这个就叫做听开攀。好啦，学完听开攀之后呢，我们学一下什么叫做听开 production 了。咁聽開 production 呢，原來我係將幾隻 CD 係擺喺聽開 palm 嘅位置，即係咁樣啦。咁我變出嚟嘅時呢，我係將我哋右手嘅無名指同埋手指尾呢要頂住喺 CD 下面喎，跟住我哋用中指同埋食指呢將 CD 夾佢出嚟，即係咁樣啦。一夾出嚟嘅時候呢，無名指將佢向上頂上去，你再动起，推出嚟，动起，推出嚟，动起。好啦，后面睇，咁我手指公就系、固定咗 CD 就 OK 噶啦，咁唔需要穿到好落嘅。无名指推出嚟，动起去，推出嚟，动起去，推出嚟，动起去。好啦，咁同 perfect production 一樣啦，我哋變咗出嚟嘅時候呢，手背對住觀眾，我哋呢就手伸直去，拉入嚟，拉入嚟，一拉一同一時間將 CD 動起去，呢、這個呢就叫做聽開 production。好啦，跟住我哋讲下 CD transfer 系点做咯。咁 CD transfer 系咩用呢？原来就系胶袋只 CD 变走之后，双手系冇嘢嘅，跟住将只 CD 变翻出嚟。好啦，咁我哋讲下点做咯。一开始我哋将只 CD 变走去啦，我哋可以咁样变走去啦，跟住 CD 收喺呢个位置。我哋咧转个身过嚟嘅时候咧，原来要将左手偷偷地将只 CD 偷落去左手度，咁右手俾人睇冇嘢，就变翻 CD 出嚟。咁成个过程系点做嘅呢？首先我哋要学下点样变走 CD 先啦。我哋将只 CD 用右手嘅食指、中指夹住佢啦，咁样，跟住你左手可以咁样打环扫一扫，一扫嘅时候咧，我哋将只 CD。夹落去 perfect palm 嘅位置，即系咁样啦。后面睇，我谂夹落去之后咧，我哋咧只手指即系伸直噶啦，一扫过就伸直去啦。咁左手同一时间俾人睇系冇嘢嘅。后面睇。好啦，咁样咧，我哋变咗 CD 之后咧，可以胶带双手冇嘢啦。跟住咧，我哋要将只 CD 偷偷地交去左手度咯。咁你系点做呢？将身转过嚟嘅时候，我哋咧将只左手掂住 CD 一路过嚟。好啦，咁过嚟嘅时候咧，我记住只 CD 保持个水平角度，咁只手咧喺前面可以遮住 CD 边嘅，咁就唔好露出嚟啦。变走去啦，摆到过嚟嗰时遮住佢。好啦，跟住过呢度之后咧，即系左手嘅手指公穿落个窿嗰度，即系呢度啦。咁右手嘅手指公就可以离开啦，穿落去。咁咧右手可以俾人睇，冇嘢啦。嚟多次啦，扫唔见咗，摆上嚟，过嚟，揸住佢，左右手冇嘢。变翻出嚟冇问题啦，将只 CD 咧，好似听开 production 咁样，将佢变出嚟得噶啦，即系咁样。好啦，成个过程，扫唔见咗，胶带冇嘢，落上嚟，转过嚟，俾人睇右手冇嘢啦，左手将佢变翻出嚟，咁呢个就系 CD transfer 啦。Thank you. 好啦，跟住咧，我哋讲下 mini CD 点样可以将佢做变出嚟，同埋变走佢啦嘛。好啦，咁咧，首先我哋学下点样就变出嚟啦。咁我哋亦都系可以用呢个 perfect palm 呢个位置去将啲 CD 收喺手嘅。嗱，首先咧，我哋将啲 CD 同大嗰啲一样啦，即系普通嗰啲 size 一样啦，摆喺手呢个位置，无名指顶住落个窿嗰度。咁保持水平嘅时候咧，公众就见唔到 CD 噶啦。咁样啦，一样啦。变出嚟方法都一样啦。手指公将面头嘅 CD 推出嚟，食指将佢揿落去，推出嚟揿落去，推出嚟揿落去。好啦，咁啊前面睇就系咁样嘅，推出嚟揿落去，推出嚟揿落去，推出嚟揿落去。后面睇，推揿落去，推出嚟揿落去，推出嚟揿落去。好啦，咁我哋真正变出嚟嘅时一样啦，都系要喺呢边啦，只手伸直，跟住变出嚟，变出嚟，变出嚟，变出嚟。咁呢个咧就系 mini CD 嘅 perfect production 啦。好啦，跟住我哋讲下咧 ，mini CD 点样可以用 10K palm 去揸住 CD， 同埋点样做 10K production 啦。好啦，咁咧我哋将几只 CD 摆喺 10K palm 嘅位置啦。咁因为咧啲 mini CD 佢比较细啦，咁所以我哋手指公咧就唔需要穿落个窿里面啦，或者型咧可以系揿最侧边啦，即系掉侧边。咁摆呢个位置咧，呢、這个就叫 10K palm 嘅位置啦。前面看就是这样的，这些 CD 呢记住要保持水平，后面看就是这样啦。好了，我再变出来怎么变的呢？前面看啦，无名指我将最底的那只将它拉出来，跟着食指去帮助它夹它出来，拉出来夹它出来，拉出来夹出来。好了，后面看是怎样的呢？保持水平啦，中指拉出嚟，食指將佢撳直佢，拉夾出嚟，拉夾出嚟。好啦，下面睇啦，中指拉，食指夾佢出嚟，拉夾佢出嚟，拉夾出嚟，拉夾出嚟。真正要變佢出嚟嘅時咧，一樣啦，我哋咧喺呢邊啦，伸隻手。跟住拉咗出嚟啦，咁样。好啦，咁大家学识呢个方法之后咧，咁咧就可以试下将啲 mini CD 变出嚟啦，咁样。呢个系一个非常好用嘅方法，呢个就叫做 10K production。好啦，跟住咧，我哋又讲下点样可以做个mini CD 嘅 transfer 啦。首先，我哋将只 CD 变走佢啦。咁点变走呢？咁样将佢唔见咗啦。咁我哋 transfer 嘅过嚟嘅时候咧，偷偷地将交喺左手度，俾人睇右手冇嘢啦，再变翻佢出嚟。好啦，咁成个过程实际系点嘅呢？我想讲下点样将只 CD 变走佢啦。前面睇右手揸住只 CD 啦，左手攞落去，咁其实咧只 CD 偷地将佢摆落去右手呢个 10K palm 嘅位置，咁当然你又冇啦，夹咗喺度。好啦，后面睇啦，嗱，只手摆喺度啦，跟住右手将 CD 咧摆喺 10K palm 嘅位置。嚟一次啦，呢度遮上嚟，夹落嚟呢个位置，出嚟，咁样。好啦，咁前面睇咧，就直拎咗嚟啦，跟住佢咧就会冇咗啦。咁 CD keep 住喺 10K palm 位置啦，观众就唔会知道啦。 好啦，跟住咧，我哋再轉個身過嚟咧，就將 CD 偷地交去左手度喎。咁點做呢？嗱，變走個 CD 之後，跟住咧，我哋將兩手靠埋一齊啦。靠埋一齊嘅時候，左手嘅食指同埋中指咧，要用個手背遮住嘅時候，夾實隻細嘅 CD 去。嗱，側邊睇就咁樣噶喎。靠埋一齊嘅時候，呢隻手指咧夾住呢度去。啊，夾住之後咧，我哋轉身過嚟嘅時候，一路轉身，一路將你嘅 CD 咧夾入去左手聽階 palm 嘅位置，即係呢度啦。夾落嚟啦，咁樣睇啦，夾落嚟，跟住一路過嚟咧，將佢轉落去聽階 palm 嘅位置。咁右手就可以分開啦，俾人睇右手冇嘢。咁而家 CD 咧，原來去咗左手聽階 palm 嘅位置啦。嗱，嚟一次啦喎。变走去啦，唔见咗啦，手靠埋一齐嘅时候，夹住佢啦呢度，过嚟，咁落咗左手听下 palm 位置啦，一睇冇嘢，就再变出嚟啦，咁变出嚟咧就同听开普通上一样啦，将佢夹出嚟啫，好啦，嚟一次啦，变走去啦，唔见咗，靠埋一齐嘅时候。夹住佢，交嚟左手，右手冇嘢，变翻出嚟。好啦，呢位咧就系 Mini CD Transfer 啦。好啦，跟住咧，我哋要讲下呢个 Free CD Fingertip Production 系点做法啦。咁咧，大家都见到效果啦。其实咧就系将三隻 CD 搭埋一齊啦，跟住逐隻逐隻將佢變落去每一隻手指嘅手指尖嗰度，結果就變成咁樣啦。咁咧就令人感覺上好似 CD 咧喺手指尖嗰度變出嚟咁樣啦。咁呢個咧有啲難度咯，咁我哋點做法呢？首先我將三隻 CD 啦搭埋一齊，跟住咧擺喺 perfect palm 嘅位置。但咧，我哋今次咧唔系用无名指啦，我用手指尾穿落个窿嗰度拧住佢。好啦，咁上面睇手指尾喺度啦，下面睇就系咁样啦。好啦，跟住咧，我哋咧将 CD 逐只逐只变出嚟嘅时候咧，用手指公将第一只推出嚟。好啦，上面睇推出嚟。好啦，当呢个窿咧离开咗呢个啲搭叠之后咧，我哋就用食指将佢穿到个窿下面，穿落去，前面睇，穿落去，下面睇，穿落去，即系咁做法啦。推出嚟，食指穿落去，下面睇，推出嚟，穿落去。好啦，咁第一隻冇问题啦，推出嚟之后呢穿入去 ,ok, 跟住呢我哋就要推第二隻啦，第二隻呢一样啦，用手指公将佢推出嚟，不过今次呢我哋就向呢个方向推啦，咁就唔好向第一隻碟嘅方向推，另一个方向向上推，推出嚟之后呢我哋用隻中指穿落呢个窿嗰度，方法同第一隻一样啦，穿落个窿嗰度。好啦，在前面看第一隻在這裡，跟住手指公將第二隻推出來，推出來的時候呢中指將它穿到個洞那裡，我拿開這隻給大家看看，推出來中指穿到個洞那裡，就是這樣。好啦，整個過程做一次了，第一隻手指公推出來，食指穿落去啦，第二隻又系啦，手指公推出嚟，今次咧用中指呢度穿落去，系咁啊，穿落去。好啦，穿晒之后咧，手指公可以出翻嚟 hold 翻实啲碟啦。咁咧，你感觉到佢唔跌出嚟咧，就 OK 啦。咁咧可以俾人睇三隻碟喺手指尖嗰度啦。好啦，下面睇睇一次啦，第一隻穿落去。第二隻穿落去， 再投你一次啊！咁样，第一只出去，推出嚟，穿落去啦。第二只推出嚟，穿落去，变成咁样。下面就咁啦。好啦，咁如果咧你左手同右手咧都做得好嘅时候咧，咁我哋就可以同一时间用两只手嚟做啦。左手一样，又系手指尾穿落个窿度啦。我咁样先俾人睇，每边都系得一只嘅啫。跟住你可以交叉手啦，第一只推出嚟，直指穿落去啦，第一个窿穿落去啦，跟住中指穿落去第二只度。好啦，做咗之后咧，将只手反转俾人睇，咁、那个感觉咧就会好似系一只变变反转，变咗三只喺每一只手嗰度啦。咁我哋后睇一次下面点做咯，咁样嗱，呢、这个下面嚟噶，第一只推出嚟，推第二只夹好咗，俾人睇，咁样啦，一、二、三，好啦，咁呢个手法咧亦都系练习啦，因为咧我哋呢只碟里面咧有好多其他效果咧都系用。这个手法去做的，那大家一定要练熟一点这个手法了。好啦，跟住咧，我哋就学下点样去将啲碟咧变走啦。咁呢个咧就叫做 CD fingertip vanish。咁头先我哋学咗啦，点样将 CD 逐只逐只变去我手指尖嗰度啦，系咪咁样？咁原来咧，我可以将 CD 咧变翻一只嘅。咁系点做呢？原来即系咁样做法，变翻一只噶啦。
The method is actually placing the first finger CD onto the middle finger CD, then place both of them onto the little finger CD. From the top, first, we take our first finger away from the hole, then use our thumb to push the first CD forward. And place it onto the second CD.Insert the middle finger into the holes of those two CDs. It looks like those two CDs have changed to one. Try it again. Three CDs. Clip the CD between our thumb and first finger. Then take our thumb away from the hole. Push the CD forward so that it will be on top of the second CD. After this is done, insert our middle finger into the holes of both CDs.This is the first step. The second step is to place those two CDs onto the first CD. We need to use our first finger to push the two CDs stack downward. Take our middle finger away from the hole, push those two CDs downward. Insert our little finger into the holes of all those three CDs. They will appear as one. We do this again. First step. Take the first finger away from the hole.And push the CD forward. Insert our middle finger into the holes. Second step, take the middle finger away from the hole and push the CDs downward out our first finger. Okay, let us have a look from the back. Here we have three CDs. Clip the first CD by our thumb. Take the first finger away from the hole, push it towards the middle finger.Insert our middle finger into the holes. Put the first finger on the top edge. Push the CDs downward. We look at that again from this angle. This is the first step. After this is done, do the second step. normal speed. We have 3 CDs here. 1, 2, 3 CDs have changed to 1. 1, 2, 3 CDs have changed to 1. From the back. 1, 2. One, two. After you have learned this technique, you will know how to produce 3 CDs from 1 and vanish them. For the next move, I'll show you how to combine these techniques to create another effect. I have already shown you how to do the fingertip production and vanish. Now I'll show you how to combine these two effects into a short routine. To do the preparation, we hold 3 CDs in our right hand and the other 3 CDs in our left hand. Do the fingertip production by our right hand so that it will have 3 CDs showing, while another 3 CDs stack is showing as 1 CD in our left hand. Now, we are ready to go. First, we wave our hands upward and downward. At the same time, we have to do the vanish and production secretly. Our right thumb pushes the top CD forward so that it will go over the second CD and hold them as one. At the same time, our left hand pushes the top CD forward onto our left first finger. Then 2 CDs will be shown in our left hand. Do it again. When waving our hands, our right hand vanishes 1 CD and our left hand produces 1. This creates an illusion that 1 CD in our right hand has been magically transferred to our left hand. Now we have 2 CDs on both hands. Next, we're going to produce 1 more in our left hand and vanish 1 more in our right hand. We wave our hands once again. Our right first finger pushes those 2 CDs onto the middle finger downward so that it will go over the little finger CD and becomes 1. At the same time, our left thumb pushes the second CD forward to our middle finger, so it will have 3 CDs showing in our left hand. We do this again in slow motion. 3 CDs in our right hand and 1 CD in our left hand. Wave our hands, vanish 1 in our right hand and produce 1 in our left hand. Wave the hands again, vanish 1 more in our right hand and produce 1 more in our left hand. It will look like that 2 CDs in our right hand have been transferred to our left hand. Now we have 3 CDs in the left hand and only 1 in the right hand. Try that again. Show the CDs to the spectators. 1, 2, and it is done. From the back, wave our hands, vanish 1 in our right hand and produce 1 in our left hand. Wave the hands again, our right first finger pushes the edge of the top CDs towards the little finger, and our left thumb pushes the second CD forward to the middle finger. It will be like this. In normal speed. 1, 2, 2 CDs have been transferred. This is a very interesting effect that puts the fingertip vanish and fingertip production together. Once you have mastered these techniques, you can try to create your own effects. Now I'm going to show you how to do the melody production using the fingertip production technique. First, put a few CDs in a stack in our right hand with our little finger inserting into the hole. Do a 3 CDs fingertip production. After this is done, throw the first and middle finger CD away with the help of the thumb. We have one CD showing now. Do the fingertip production again. In this way, we can do the production, throw them away, and produce the CDs again continuously. Do that again. 1, 2, throw them away. Produce the CDs again. When doing the production, we have to wave our hand in an up and down motion. From the back. 1, 2, throw them away. 1, 2, produce the CDs again. After you have mastered the technique of fingertip production, it will have no problem for you to do this effect. Just need to do the fingertip production twice. Very simple. Now I will show you a more advanced version of fingertip production, which will produce 4 CDs in our hand. It is actually an extended effect of the 3 CDs fingertip production. For this effect, we need to use 4 CDs. First, hold 4 CDs in our perfect palm position, just similar to the 3 CDs fingertip production. Insert the little finger into the hole of the CDs. Do a 3 CDs fingertip production first. Now we should have 2 CDs on the little finger. Here is the way to produce the 4th one. Put our thumb on the top of those 2 CDs on the little finger. At the same time, use our ring and little fingers to push the top CD forward. It will look like that we have 4 CDs produced on our fingers. Do it again. We have 4 CDs in a stack. Do a 3 CDs fingertip production first. Then hold the little finger CDs by the thumb. Take the little finger away from the hole of the CDs. Push the bottom CD forward by the ring and little fingers. Now, you should have 4 CDs showing to the spectators. From the back, put the CDs together. 1, 2. Then clip the bottom CD by the thumb and the palm. Take the little finger away from the hole and push the bottom CD forward by the ring and little fingers. These 2 fingers will be straight after this is done. From the front, it will be like this. Okay, we do that again in slow motion. 1, 2, 3. From the back. 1, 2, 3. After we have mastered this technique, we can do it faster. 1, 2, 3. 4 CDs are produced. This is the 4 CDs fingertip production. After you have learned the four CDs fingertip position, we can try another version of it, which is more advanced. The name reverse position means that except doing the position with the palm facing the spectators, we can also do that with the palm turning over. This effect is very spectacular. How do we do this? Let us take a look at it. Put four CDs in a stack and hold them in a perfect palm position with the little finger inserting into the holes of the CDs. Do a three CDs fingertip position first. Then move our hand forward, put our thumb under the bottom of the little finger CD. Take the little finger away from the hole. Those two CDs originally held by the little finger will now be kept in place by the upward force of the thumb and the downward force of the CD on the first finger. Then put our little finger on the top of those two CDs. Now those two CDs will be held by the thumb and the little finger. After that, separate those two CDs by pushing the bottom CD upward by the thumb and pulling the top CD downward by the little finger. We'll get four CDs in a star shape. Try that again. Do a three CDs fingertip position. 1, 2. When moving our arm forward, at the same time, we have to put our thumb under the bottom of the little finger CD and put our little finger over the top CD. Push the bottom CD upward by our thumb and pull the top CD downward by our little finger. We'll get four CDs on our fingers. From the back, 1, 2. Then put our thumb under the bottom CD and take the little finger away from the hole. Put the little finger over the top CD in this position. The thumb pushes the bottom CD upward and the little finger pulls the top CD downward. It will be like this from the back, and we will get the star shape from the front. We do that once again. From the front, 1, 2. The thumb is under the bottom CD and the little finger is over the top CD. Separate those two CDs like this. From the back, 1, 2. Then separate those two bottom CDs. After you have mastered this technique, you can do this effect by both hands. It will be very spectacular as a total of 8 CDs are showing on your hands. I'll show you what the effect looks like. We need 8 CDs this time. This is the starting position. Do the 3 CDs fingertip position by both hands first. Then produce the 4th one. Now we get 8 CDs on our fingers. Practice more and you'll be able to master this spectacular effect easily. We have already learned how to do the fingertip position with regular size CDs. Now we will try to do that with mini CDs. Usually, we will produce 4 mini CDs in each hand instead of 3 because the mini CD is smaller and it will look better if we get 4 in our hand. I'll show you the technique now. First, we put a stack of 4 mini CDs in the perfect palm position, just similar to what we did for regular size CD. The difference is that we do not insert our little finger into the holes of the mini CDs, but insert our ring finger into them instead. The ring finger just needs to keep the mini CDs in place. Now, we push the top mini CD forward by the thumb and insert the first finger into the hole of it. After it's done, we push the second mini CD forward by the thumb again and insert the middle finger into the hole of it. Okay, now I'll show you how to produce the mini CDs on the little finger. Use the thumb to push the third mini CD downward, then insert the little finger into the hole of it. The ring finger just keeps the bottom mini CD in place. Now we have 4 mini CDs showing to the spectators. Do it once again. Push the first mini CD forward, insert the first finger into the hole. Then push the second mini CD forward, insert the middle finger into the hole. Push the third mini CD downward, insert the little finger into the hole. We have 4 mini CDs on our fingers now. From the back, produce the first mini CD, then produce the second one, and produce the third one. Show that to the spectators. Do that once again in slow motion. Produce the first mini CD, and the second one, and the third one. It is done. From the back, 1, 2, 3. After you have mastered this technique, you can also do this spectacular mini CDs fingertip production. Now we'll try to do this effect by both hands. It will be very eye-catching. Put 4 mini CDs in our left hand and another 4 mini CDs in our right hand. Produce the first one by both hands at the same time, then produce the second one, and finally produce the third one. Turn the hands over to show those 8 mini CDs to the spectators. This is a nice effect and hope it will not be very hard for you to master this technique. Now I'm going to show you a short routine that will change 1 CD to 3 and then change those 3 CDs back to 1. It will look very nice if you can do it smoothly. First of all, we have to hold a few CDs in both hands. For easier learning, I'll show you how to do the effects with my right hand only for the time being, and we'll do that with both hands later. Okay, hold a stack of 4 CDs in our right hand like this. This is the perfect palm position with our ring finger inserting into the hole of the CD stack. Do a single perfect position, then we are going to change it to 3 CDs. How do we do this? Move our hand downward and at the same time, our thumb pulls the top CD backward so that the top CD will go towards our body. Turn the original single CD horizontal to the other CDs. It will look like that there are 3 CDs in our hand now. Try it again. Do a single perfect position. Move our hand downward and produce 2 more CDs. Take a look from the back. Produce a CD first. While moving our hand downward, our thumb pulls the top CD towards our body like this. Turn the first CD flat on the other CDs. Then we will have 3 CDs now. Do this again. Produce a CD. pull the top CD backward, turn the first CD to a horizontal position, and we will get three CDs. Have a look from this angle. Produce a CD, pull the top CD backward, and turn the original CD horizontal, and this is done. Do it again in slow motion. Do a single perfect position. Pull the top CD backward and turn the original CD horizontal. We'll have three CDs in our hand. After we have learned how to change one CD to three, we can learn how to change three CDs back to one. Actually, the steps are the same as previous, but in reverse order. Show those three CDs to the spectators. Turn the first CD up to a vertical position. A thumb pushes the last CD back to its original position. There is only one CD in our hand. This creates an illusion that three CDs have suddenly changed to one. Do it again. Three CDs here. Turn the first CD vertical. Push the last CD to its original position. Show the front CD to the spectators only. From the back, turn the first CD vertical. Push the last CD to its original position. Show the front CD to the spectators. Now we can combine both effects into one. Produce one CD. Change that to three. Change them back to one. After we have mastered these techniques, we can try to do the whole routine by both hands. First, hold 4 CDs in each hand, cross our hands to do the production. Produce one from the right hand, another from the left hand. Show the spectators that we get one CD in each hand. Move both hands downward and change each CD to 3 by using the method we learned before. The spectators will see that we have 6 CDs in our hands. We can try to change them back to 1 now. Our hands go up and at the same time, change those 3 CDs to 1. After that, we can do the production again. Drop the CD in the right hand and produce one more. Drop the CD in the left hand and produce one more. Then, we have our hands away from each other and cross them again in another position. When our hands touch each other, we immediately do the fresh 3 CDs appearance again. Show those 6 CDs to the spectators. Try that again. Produce one in the right hand, another in the left hand. Cross our hands in another way, and when they touch each other again, produce 6 CDs simultaneously. I'll do it again from the very beginning. Hold the CDs in our hands. Do a single production by each hand. Move our hands down to show that we have 6 CDs now. Move our hands up to change those 6 CDs into 2 only. Drop it and produce one more by each hand. Cross our hands and when they touch each other, change them to 6 quickly. Show the spectators that you have 6 CDs again. This is a very nice routine. Practice more to make it perfect. Now I'm going to show you how to do the split fan production with regular CDs. Hold a few CDs in our hand and insert our little finger into the hole. If you have been using some special CDs such as those with bigger holes, then you can insert your ring finger into the hole. However, for regular CDs, as the hole is too small, our ring finger will be too thick to insert into it. So it is better to use our little finger instead. It is like this. After we have got those CDs in the perfect palm position, we can try to do a fanning with them. To fan them, bend our thumb and put it at the edge of the CDs. Push the CDs upward. It is similar to the cuff fanning. Practice more and you can get the feeling on how to fan the CDs. It is not so good, if you just get two CDs showing in your hand after the fanning like this. You just need to bend our thumb and use it to push the CDs upward. After you have got the feeling, you can fan it well. Next, we have to drop the CDs on the table or on the floor. While waving our hand up and down, we have to do a secret move to steal the CDs and keep them in our palm. Just need to bend the little finger. The CD stack kept by our little finger will be lifted up. Keep these CDs horizontal to the floor. From the front, when waving our hand, lift the CD stack up by the little finger. The spectators will not know that the CDs are concealed in our palm, as this secret move is covered by the up and down motion of our hand. From the side, lift the CDs up. From the back, it is like this. Use the force of the little finger to lift the CDs up. The spectators can only see the front CDs. Do that again. Fan the CDs, keep a stack on the little finger. Wave our hand up and down, hide the CD stack in the palm secretly. From the back, fan the CDs, wave the hand, and hide the CDs in the palm. After that, we can drop the front CDs on the table. Wave our hand up and down, hide the CDs in the palm, and drop the front CDs. After we've dropped the CDs, it is very important that our first finger is raised, as it needs to hide the edges of those hidden CDs. Do not use too many CDs, otherwise the edge will be very thick and cannot be hidden by the first finger. When we drop the front CDs, the spectators will think that we have dropped all the CDs. At that moment, we have to produce the CD fan again immediately. Do not keep the CD still without any motion. Turn our hand over to produce another CD fan in the same way as before. Okay, we lift up the CDs by our little finger and hide them in the palm again. Drop the CDs on the table again. Straighten the first finger to hide the edges of the CDs. Produce a CD fan again. Our thumb pushes the CD upward. We will get the final CD fan. Let us try that again. Do a fanning first. Move up and down and drop the CDs. Do the second time. Drop the CDs again and produce the final fan. From the back, fan the CDs, lift them up, drop the front CDs, do the fanning again, lift the back CDs up, and drop the front CDs. Fan the CDs again, and it is done. Practice more on this split fan production, then we can try another version of it, which will be explained in the next chapter. We have already learned the split fan production. Now I'll show you how to do it at the front, which is called the front split fan production. The starting position is the same as split fan production. Hold the CDs in the palm with the little finger inserting into the hole. For the front split fan, we have to do it at the front like this. First, bend the thumb until it is on the edge of the top CD. Push a few CDs at the top forward to produce the fan. After that, with an up and down motion, put the back CD stack down so that it will be in a horizontal position and will be hidden in the palm. The spectators will not see the hidden CDs as they are hidden behind the front CDs in our hand. From this angle, it is actually the same as the previous move that the back CDs will be hidden in the palm by an up and down motion. Move up and down and hide the CD stack at the back. From the back, it is like this. Keep the hidden CDs horizontally. Now, drop the front CDs on the table. When this is done, straighten our first finger to hide the edges of the hidden CDs immediately. Do the CD fan again. Hide the back CDs in the palm while moving our hand up and down. Drop the front CDs again. Produce the final fan. Just need to produce a few fans and the routine is done. After you have mastered the techniques of this and the previous moves, then we can do that with both hands simultaneously.